Greetings. I had a question from someone trapped in Islam. Why Jesus says our Father, but he never said mine? And that is clearly a question they have been wrongly taught to ask, because it is based on a clearly disprovable false claim. He never said mine or my Father. Well, how many times did Jesus teach saying our Father? To be consistent, I'm going to do my analysis with King James. You could use another translation, as long as you count both phrases in the same translation. Matthew 6:9, after this manner, therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That's one. Luke 11:2, and he said unto them, when you pray, say, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. That's two. And that's it in the King James. Jesus taught us to pray calling God our Father. So then I performed the same search for my Father on Bible Gateway. Matthew 7:21, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. That's one. Matthew 10:32, whosoever shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. That's two. Matthew 10:30, but whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. That's three. Notice, to be clear, Jesus' Father is in heaven. Jesus means God. Matthew 11:27, all things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. That's four. Matthew 12:50, for whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother. That's five. Matthew 15:13, but he answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted up. That's six. Matthew 16:17, and Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto you, but my Father which is in heaven. That's seven. Matthew 18:10, take heed that you despise not one of these little ones, for I say unto you that in heaven their angels do always behold the face of my Father which is in heaven. That's eight. Matthew 18:19, again I say unto you that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that you shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. That's nine. Matthew 18:35, so likewise shall my heavenly Father do also unto you, if you from your hearts forgive not every one his brother their trespasses. That's ten. Matthew 20:23, and he saith unto them, you shall drink indeed of my cup, and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared of my Father. That's 11. Matthew 24:36, but of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. That's 12. Matthew 25:34, then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. That's 13. Now that verse caught my eye when I was researching all these places where Jesus calls God my Father. Let's take a look at the context of this verse. Matthew 25:31, when the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. This is all nations being gathered on the day of judgment, the last day. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand and the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, Come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. This is the Son of Man still speaking, and all nations will be judged by him. The Son of Man is now called the King, and he calls God my Father. And he, the King, the Son of Man, is judging all mankind. Let that sink in, O Muslim. Matthew 26:29. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. That's 14. Matthew 26:39. And he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it were possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt. That's 15. Matthew 26:42. He went away again a second time and prayed, saying, O my Father, if this cup may not pass away from me, except I drink it, thy will be done. That's 16. Matthew 26:53. Thinkest you that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels? That's 17. That is only the examples from the Gospel of Jesus recorded by Matthew. But if 17 examples are not enough, there are many more. The question really comes down to people called Muslim wanting the truth or not wanting the truth. I try to respect people who call themselves Muslim, but people who do not respect the truth have issues with God, who is the truth. I pray that you would desire the truth, and you would respect what Jesus said. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.